best a man can get.
Welcome in to First Things First. I'm Sarah Kustak in for Jenna Wolf. That's the Hall of Famer, Chris Carter, and filling in for Nick Wright is Chris Canty, Chris Broussard. Guys, how are we doing this morning?
Doing good. Welcome back.
Great show yesterday.
Absolutely.
The bosses from L.A. called me and everything, and they were very, very happy with the show and everything. You guys did a great job. So today, the mandate is good yesterday, but great today.
I like it.
That's a good plan.
I'm with that.
Let's get it rolling. All right.
My camera guy, Jay, he ain't really into us today. I'm going to have to bring him to life, lay some hands on him.
We begin today's show.
He likes it.
With Patrick Mahomes. Last season, he threw for 50 touchdowns and 5,000 yards, but the Chiefs fell short of the ultimate prize, the Super Bowl. Mahomes, he says he's not complacent and has his eye on the Lombardi Trophy.
Until you win that Super Bowl, I don't think you can be complacent with anything. Being that close last year, you want to find a way to win it. And until you're able to do that and able to do it multiple times, I mean, you're never going to be complacent with where you're at.
All right, Canty, so what is the ceiling for Mahomes?
Well, I think he's shown that he's got the potential to be one of the all-time greats in this game at the quarterback position, MVP in his first full season as a starter. But I'm really impressed with Pat Mahomes' maturity. The fact that he has enough self-awareness to understand that he's got to grow his knowledge base, he's got to continue to try to improve, that's the important thing. I mean, Tom Brady's going into his 20th season, and there's still things that he's learning. He talks about trying to get better. He always looks for something in the offseason to work on. So when I hear Pat Mahomes say that, I'm encouraged because I know he can potentially improve. And going into year two, he can build on the success that he had in year one, even if the statistics don't bear that out. I'm not coming into 2019 expecting Pat Mahomes to throw for 50 touchdowns, but I do believe he can have a bigger impact in terms of his team being more successful, being able to win more games, and hopefully being able to take that next step to get to the Super Bowl. But I'm really impressed by hearing what he's been saying throughout the offseason. Mm-hmm. Eric Bieniemy, their offensive coordinator, was talking about how he's one of those guys that comes in after the game with a list of things that he felt like he could have done better in the game. He focuses on all of those things that he needs to improve. So when you have a quarterback that's a student of the game, I think that puts your team in a really good place.
Look, I love him. I mean, I expect a huge year. You know, huge. I think he will throw for over 5,000 yards again.
Okay.
Because
most of us think, after seeing a season like that, that he would come back just a little bit. But
touchdowns, he may not get 50. I think he's definitely getting at least 40. I have a bet with Rob Parker that he's getting 40. So I'm going there. I think in the 45-ish range, you know, give or take a couple. But look, the thing is, remember last year, obviously they're in a strong division. And every team he played against that saw him twice in the division, Oakland, the Chargers, Denver, he threw for more yards the second time around. And in most cases, more touchdowns, too.
Great point.
So, you know, he's adjusting. It's not like, oh, once they see him the second time, they're going to adjust to him. And he's a young guy, so that, you know, that foils young guys a lot. All the intangibles, we know the physical gifts, but the intangibles are there. You know, you mentioned Bieniemy, but the teammates, the other people in the organization, they just rave about him, and not just the arm, not just the athleticism. They rave about the work ethic. They rave about how he feels and relates with his other teammates and his leadership. So I don't see, you know, I know we got a lot of young guys putting up some numbers. Carson Wentz and Baker Mayfield looks good, and I don't want to just seem like I'm a prisoner of the moment. But I see this, it's a cliche, sky is the limit for this guy. And I'm going to be honest, I think he has a chance to end up as the greatest of all time.
Whoa, okay.
Wow, okay.
Okay, now did you write that down?
You obviously have to win, right? I don't think he has to win six like Tom Brady, but he has to win, and he's obviously got the Andy Reid coach, at least for now. That's going to help him with his numbers.
Yes.
And they got a chance to win Super Bowls. If he wins one this year, then I think, you know, this guy's just going to roll.
Well, the one thing that I always talk about in the NFL, it becomes very, very important, is institutional talent. That means who's selecting the players, what type of culture. And you guys have made some great points. Him being with Andy Reid, especially because Andy hadn't won the Super Bowl. So Andy is still hungry later in his career, but he has tutored. He has, not compared to some other people, it's a myth. Andy Reid has developed all different superstar quarterbacks, journeyman quarterbacks, middle round draft picks. So for me, Patty Mahomes, there's some templates out there. Is he going to be a chance to potentially compare to Tom Brady? Or will he be just always a great thrower of the football like my good friend Dan Marino? Because Dan Marino, if you do a comparison with them when they first start out, their first year that they started, here's a graphic, very, very similar. Dan Marino, this is 1984. Dan Marino lit the world on fire. Patty Mahomes did the same thing last year. But as you can see, that was Dan Marino's first year that he was all pro three straight years. But then after that, things change. It was hard for him to even get 30 touchdowns. So we've only seen a few quarterbacks. So when you say, man, he has the potential, that's not just shock TV. That's not just you saying something. He has the arm talent. He's got the institutional talent with Andy Reid and the general manager there. And you can see with the players around him. They even got better this year. Mm-hmm. Because as an organization, I can tell you, they did not think Tyreek Hill was going to be available for them, especially for the first half of the season. And that's why they went out in the second round and got another playmaker from the University of Georgia who fits into their system. So for me, I wouldn't be shocked to see him duplicate the yardage or maybe even have more yardage. Touchdowns will come back. I do believe in his first 5 years, he will throw for 50 touchdowns again. Yes. He's a special kid. Mm-hmm. He's got special ability, and you can see that anytime you watch a game or watch the tape.
Well, see, look at the speed. I mean, you mentioned Tyreek Hill. Now you got Mecole Hardman, who ran a 4.3.
Mm-hmm.
Think of how much that's going to just open things up for Travis Kelce. You know, the running game, I mean, he's got weapons galore.
Well, and so he's got the weapons, and we just showed the numbers. I mean, mm-hmm. all of us watching last season, mm-hmm. it was eye-popping. But, Canty, for someone who played in the league, you said he's a student of the game. Mm-hmm. You're expecting improvement. What specifically can he do heading into the season or that you're looking for to see some of those jumps?
Well, a couple of things that he's talked about this offseason. Number one, his footwork in the pocket, making sure that when the pocket is clean, that he delivers the football and he focuses on the fundamental aspects of throwing the ball down the field, okay? Because Pat Mahomes has made some off-schedule plays. He can make off-platform throws, but you can't become enamored with that as a young player. You have to go back to your fundamentals. And so when the X's and O's are drawn up and then it executed according to how you look at it in the game plan meetings, go ahead and take those opportunities to make a good, strong throw. I think that's one of the things that he's got to improve on in terms of just understanding that when the play is there, be willing to take the layup. Don't always try to take the three-point shot. Don't always try to push the ball down the field. And that's the thing that I'm concerned with for him, having so much success as a young player. His ability to be patient within that offense. Because as a defender, we want to make you go the long, hard way. We want to make you go 8, 10, 12 mm-hmm. plays in order to score. This is a quick strike, big play offense. They were 27th in time of possession, but they were first in yards and points. So Pat Mahomes learning how to be patient, learning how to take those checkdowns, take those open receivers underneath, I think that's going to be critical for him. Yeah. When you look at a player in a scheme, mm-hmm. it usually takes the NFL about a year to catch up to what they're doing.
Yes.
So now that they've had an entire offseason to put his game under a microscope, he's going to see some new looks from defenses. He's got to be patient because he has to understand they're going to try to force him to make mistakes. And if he can be patient enough, I think that will tell the tale in terms of how effective that offense will be in his second season.
Yeah, you make two great points. One about the patience, because as a young player, when you've seen success, sometimes you think you know more than what you really understand. And it's going to take the league about a year. They're going to take some things away from him. But I believe that not only because of his patience, but his footwork. That's what he's got to continue to get better at because he has such great arm. And we're getting a lot of these baseball pitchers playing quarterback where they don't have to take a big step to be able to throw because they got great torque with their body. That's why Kyler can be a success with that small frame of his playing baseball, that torque. Baker Mayfield has that quick torque. Now, how consistent can his footwork be? Last year, he had 10 passes touched by the defense that could have been intercepted. Mm. So you ask him, what can he get better? He better be patient, not throwing the ball in the traffic. Because this year, that could have been 9 more interceptions added and going the other way. And with that defense, it's important that they learn how to milk the clock, because that defense doesn't get any better. there's no Super Bowl, real aspirations in Kansas City.
All right, good stuff. Coming up, does Jason Garrett need Zeke to keep his job? That's next. Run, and you can always check us out on the Fox Sports channel.
I'm ready to go do this.
We'll be right back. We do need
I like Jason. Good, Jason, you need him. It's called job security, homie. Yeah, I'm so sorry.